Hi, and welcome to Rockin' the Planet. I'm Shane. I'm so glad you could join me here just to celebrate everything that's good about Kiwi music, and I'm loving it. Wow, Elvis. I was really in need of a fix of Elvis this week, and I just decided we've got to get together with some other Elvis freaks. And I couldn't get two better Elvis freaks than these two, I tell you. Brendan Chase and, of course, Johnny Angel. Two of the best tribute Elvis artists that there are in the country and in Australasia. And I love them dearly, and they bought their costumes and they've come to talk to me about it all. Brendan, it's fantastic having you here, mate.
Thank you, Shane.
And
thank
you, Johnny.
Thank you, Johnny. Ross.
Good on you guys. You're fun guys. Hey, I'm already having a ball, and I've look, I've put in the honour. I've got the Elvis shirt on there.
Elvis and blue eyes.
But yeah, now, what does it take to become a tribute Elvis artist? I mean, you're a Takapuna boy,
yes.
Brendan. You grew up there?
No, I grew up in the South Island.
So you grew up in the South Island?
Yeah, down in the cold and the snow in a place called Twizel.
Oh, I know Twizel, yeah. There's hardly anybody there.
No.
Sorry, Twizel, and if you're watching. Anyway, look, you got this great Elvis tribute artist, Brendan Chase, and you came here and you live in Takapuna now,
yes,
you're based in Takapuna.
Yep.
And now we've got the Pacific Elvis here, yes. Johnny Angel. I love that name, Johnny Angel. Were you a Shelley Fabares fan or something? She bought that hit record out years ago. You probably weren't born.
Yeah, she's a beautiful talent. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a cool name, man.
Yeah.
It's a cool name.
Yeah. Thank you.
But having you both here anyway, you started, did you just wake up one morning and say, I want to be an Elvis tribute artist? I mean, how does it happen?
Well, it's a long story. I think for me, I've always sung as a baby, hearing Elvis on the radio, on the wireless, I guess it was in them days.
Yeah.
Saw his first concert, Aloha Elvis, and fell in love with him.
Yeah.
And I guess it wasn't until I joined the Navy and I started singing Kapahaka that I really found my voice and sort of went to the front of all the group and started singing a little harder.
You found the joy of singing.
Yeah.
And that was...
And Elvis come up sort of after that.
Now, how old were you when you saw this Aloha?
I think I would have been seven.
You were seven, so it really impressed you then.
Yeah.
At 7 years old. Yeah. Amazing. And that's when you decided, okay, Elvis, so you listen to a lot of Elvis records.
A lot of Elvis, everything.
I bet you listen to nothing else but Elvis now, I presume.
Technically, I guess that's the way I am at the moment, yeah.
Yeah. And Johnny, same for you? You were born in Samoa?
I was born in New Zealand.
Oh, you were born in New Zealand?
Born and raised
Samoan
in Greenlane. Yeah.
Okay.
My parents, Samoan. I'm proud to be Samoan
heritage.
And, of course, you know, Kiwi Samoan.
Yeah.
And, my mom and dad just raised me up with Elvis music, and I think that's where I adopted the kind of the voice, you know, the kind of.
So dad was a bit of an Elvis.
Octave,
Elvis used to sing in front of the mirror and do the bit, did he?
Yeah.
Is he watching tonight?
Hope so.
Oh, good on you. Hey, Dad. Good boy, I tell you, Johnny Angel. Anyway, and so you grew up, your parents had the music playing in the house. Everybody had the Elvis music playing in the house.
Yeah, mainly I can remember it's the movies. On Sundays, my mum and dad used to play Elvis's movies.
Oh, fantastic. The early ones.
The early
King
ones,
Creole's
King
and
Creole.
King
Creole, Love Me Tender.
Yeah, Loving You. And So that's where it all got to you. So, okay. Now, Brendan, you were in the Navy for many years.
20 years.
20 years. That's a long time.
Yeah.
You must have enlisted in the Navy, like as a young man, very, very early in the piece.
Yeah,
17,
I was just after my 17th birthday.
Okay.
I was off and away and saw the world and never looked back.
Yeah, and you became a Chief Petty Officer, I believe.
Yep.
I'm not sure what that is because I've never been in the services, but how do you get to be a Chief Petty Officer?
Just a lot of sweat, a lot of hard work, a lot of cleaning toilets.
Oh, that's okay. Just a good name, eh?
Yeah. No, it's it takes time, it evolves, and you know there's a massive career progression in the military, so it's a matter of sticking in there, and eventually you get to them dizzy heights, and you know I got there and left after 20 years and become someone else.
It's like you say, dizzy heights, you know, you're there, you've got a great career ahead of you for the rest of your life, and you're obviously married at this stage, and you've got kids as well,
three
so you've got a family and everything, so a big decision to suddenly become an Elvis tribute artist.
It's a big decision in New Zealand because New Zealand's such a small, a small country, you know, you haven't got the population that overseas has.
No.
So it's tough, but I think, you know, my passion was to sing, my passion was Elvis. So I think one foot led in front of the other foot, and the way I, and I didn't look back really.
So you discussed it with family before you gave up your day job.
Yeah, there was I wouldn't say there wasn't a sit down and have a cup of coffee over it.
Get out of here.
Edit that, but but you know, I think at the end of the day, I followed my dream.
Yeah, of course.
And it's been a journey, and it's been a really good journey. Yeah. And my journey is still sort of starting now because of what I've done this year in regards of being a tribute artist. So who knows what's going to come around the corner next year.
It's growing every day. I mean, it's just amazing how you've escalated, if you like. Yep. You've gone up and up with the Elvis tribute business.
Yep.
You both of you, Johnny and you, recently went to Australia.
Yes.
You played in Australia. Is there a train or something? It's an Elvis train.
Yeah, there is.
Now, this is an annual event that New South Wales, is it the railways put on? Or?
It's a place called Parks. So it's four hours heading inland from Sydney.
Yep. So you get on at Central Station.
Yep. And it's basically revolves around Elvis's birthday. And everywhere around the world, someone has a celebration.
This is January the 9th, I believe, is it?
During the 8th.
8th, I mean, yeah.
So... you know, someone has a big celebration, and just fortunately this thing has got so big, it's now the second biggest gathering of Elvis's and celebration in the world, next to Tupelo.
Really?
It's massive. 22,000 people show up for this event. And
just at the station?
No, at the actual park
itself. Oh, when you go there, yeah.
It's a little baby township that just swells.
Yeah.
The local residents hire the houses out for people coming in, and it's Elvis galore. Just continuously.
And the train
Elvis
carries, it got Elvis, you've got all the Elvis... tribute artists in each carriage. You've got different artists and everything else, and they're all there doing the whole thing.
Yeah, it's all about having fun, and that's what we do, eh?
You know? So you just carry on through the train. You get different Elvis on every carriage.
We have myself, Johnny, and there's two others sing on the train, and we just rotate through each carriage one after the other, and we follow like a little line.
Yeah.
Our music's playing through the train. You can sing along, and then everyone is dressed up on the train, and you might see some footage there.
I saw the dances and everything
it's crazy.
And all the Elvises and walking around the train. Everyone's
madness.
In costume and having a great time. So then you arrive at Parks, you get out of the train.
Yep. And all of everyone who were expecting you there, they're arriving on the
tarmac. And then there's a concert.
Concert every night.
Yep.
Shows, competitions. Nights? 5 nights.
Yeah, 5 nights. Wow.
So they fly in the best of the world, come over.
So they're from all over the world. Yeah. Britain. America.
One guy come from America, one from Britain. So they fly in the best of the world, and they play with the best bands, and they also run in conjunction with a Ultimate Elvis Tribute Artist contest that gets you to the World Championships if you actually win it.
Well, there is a competition now. Now, you were a semi-finalist, and you were runner-up, is that right?
Were you
the winner?
I won it.
There you go. Well done. Congratulations. No, you're the winner.
Yeah.
So you are the top Australasian Elvis Tribute Artist Award winner.
Yes, at this point in time, yeah.
And that gave you an opportunity to go to Memphis?
I'm going to Memphis on August the 10th to compete for the world title.
Oh, well done, man.
Yeah.
And, I mean, like you say, your wife must be very proud now, and the family must be feeling very secure.
Yes, she is, yeah.
And they're starting to feel good about this. This is going to be all right.
Finally, yeah.
Yeah, Dad is all No, but it's amazing, and you're doing it. Do you think you've got a long lifespan as an Elvis? I'm just curious because Elvis, died at 42 years old.
Yep.
42, he wasn't that old. So I have seen a lot of Elvises, and I've seen Elvis tribute artists, and I've seen some really old ones that don't look anything like Elvis. They just have the costume on.
Yes.
But as a performer yourself, you're one of the... I think you're great.
Thank you.
You've really got it off pat, you know, you're doing all the moves and all the stuff, and your voice is fantastic, and you're doing a great performance.
Yeah.
Do you see yourself having a longevity or the longevity of it all?
Is it lasting long? Yeah, it's a good question, because you don't get any younger, but I think my voice is getting better as time goes past. And
funny that, mine is too.
Yeah. It does, it really does. And I guess the more you study, the more... For me, is I've lost more competitions than I won.
Mm.
And I've learnt a lot out of losing competitions.
Yeah, but plus your confidence grows all
the
time.
Yeah, it does. And you get better and better and better from there. So America's going to be another step up again, because I'm now going to compete against the top 20 of the world of 2017.
Wow.
I don't think it worries me if I come last or first. First and foremost, we are keeping Elvis's memory alive.
Yeah.
And I guess without people like myself and the fans, then Elvis wouldn't be what he is today.
Definitely not. I mean, to me, it's a religion. Elvis Presley has become a religion. There are fans, we all know, around the world. I'm a fan, but not religiously. But there are people out there that are fanatics. They will not look past Elvis. There is nothing but Elvis in their life.
Yep.
Their houses are full of Elvis memorabilia.
Yep.
You don't live in that sort of situation, obviously. And Johnny, you're the same. Your parents, do they have a lot of Elvis memorabilia around them?
Not much, but they did have, you know,
paintings and things.
Yeah.
A bit of Elvis.
Yeah,
bit of Elvis.
Just a little bit.
Yeah, lots of records.
Yeah, but they, of course, they love Elvis. And,
now, you guys become really good friends, in the last few years? Because you've both been working on the same stages around the place.
Yep.
How did that evolve? You just got on like house on fire? Or?
Yeah, I think so. We've known each other for a long, long time, and I think Johnny sees me as a mentor.
Or,
you know, I always help him out and give him some good advice. And Johnny's done really well as well.
He's doing great things.
And in his own little arena of the Pacific Islanders and what he does, and that's a niche that I haven't got and can't get.
That's another thing with the Elvis impersonator. You know, it crosses all races and all sorts.
Yeah.
Like we've got here a Pacific Elvis. In Japan, they've got Elvises coming out of the doors, the windows. They're everywhere.
Yep.
And they're all little Japanese guys singing away there, but they're all doing it. And they actually, there is an Elvis look, obviously, the whole thing, the setup, the outfits. And I've got to ask you about those and the outfits. But first of all, we're going to look at you, Brendan, as Elvis. Singing a great song, one of Elvis's great songs called Poke Salad Annie.
Great song.
So check this out and watch it. You think you're watching Elvis. Go. Hope Saturday, Brendan Chase doing a fine job, rocking his socks off. And I must say, the band is fantastic. Who is that band? Is that New Zealand band?
No, that band's from Adelaide.
Adelaide?
Yep, so all the superstars that go into Australia
get
backed by that band, and they've actually backed myself here in Auckland as well. So
they're Australia's taking care of business band.
Yeah, they are. Yeah, no, they're
magnificent.
They're
yeah, great playing on there and really well supported.
Yep.
But you've got those moves.
Wow,
I like that.
It helps when you've got a big band behind you, though. So if my hands up here, I expect the band to be bang, 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 and my arm bang, 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 bang at the same time. So if it doesn't and you're out of tune, well, then something's gone wrong.
Yeah, something's happening. Anyway, Brendan, great performance.
Thank
and
you.
I just got to say, Johnny, what's your favourite Elvis song?
Oh, man, there's so many, eh? But
yes.
I like G.I. Blues.
G.I. Blues. Well, look, Johnny, I don't embarrass me, but it just happens that we've got a really good version of that by yourself. Here's Johnny Angel with G.I. Blues.
You know it, sing along. Uncle's hot, 2, 3, 4, occupation, G.I. Blues. All my G.I. head to the heels of my G.I. shoe. And if I don't go stay inside soon, I'm gonna blow up you. The front lines are pretty as flowers, but we can't make a path. The island gills as pretty as flowers, but you can't make a pass. Horns, they all wear socks, they keep a tea on the grass. Everybody sing along, come on! It's wonderful, it's amazing. Oh, my G.I. head to the heels of my Occupation G.I. Blue. Occupation G.I. Blue.
I got the hook, 2, 3, 4. Yay, G.I. Blues. I remember, look, that movie came out in 1961.
Yeah,
I think it was 61.
Like I have to turn to Brendan for that one.
I had the choice answer. Of going to a Cliff Richard concert in Sydney, his first concert in Sydney, or G.I. Blues. And a couple of my mates went to that, and I went to the Cliff Richard concert. I'm very sorry about that. So you guys won't, are you going to talk to me?
No, that's, okay. Fine, that's fine.
I did get to see the movie. But great movie, G.I. Blues, and so it's your favourite song.
Yeah, it's one of my favourites.
Okay, now before you go on stage, being Elvis, there's a character to find. You've got to be Elvis when you're out there, right?
I think so, yeah.
You really become Elvis. Yeah. I mean, you've got to think that you're Elvis. Yeah. I'm Elvis, and you get that lip and the whole thing. You've got, see, can you teach me how to do it? I've been trying that for years. I cannot get that thing going. Try it. You did it perfectly.
One of those tricks you learn over years, you know what I'm saying?
I've never seen, you did it so
natural.
Well.
It's natural.
It's a natural, you're a natural.
I'm going to practice.
But now, being able to, what do you sort of prime yourself in a dressing room and sit there and contemplate the performance and everything, go through it and start to change, you know, how you do? I do myself. I have that build up to a show and things, I don't want to be detracted after about, if it's half an hour before the show, I don't want to talk to anyone. I just want to think about what I'm doing.
Yep. I usually don't like talking to anyone.
Yeah.
If I do, then you're right, you sort of get dissuaded from it. But what I do is I don't get too emotionally involved in what I need to do on stage.
Yeah.
Because then it comes across a little bit false.
Yeah, you've got to
So it's probably a bit more natural as well. So
you've still got to get all that emotion.
Still got to get to play the part. So I always listen to a certain song. You just gave me a mountain. That's my favourite song. And and you hear Elvis's pure voice there and the big finish at the end. And
He was great on the gospel stuff.
Yeah, for sure, just, for sure. And
that's
his
where it all came from, you know. We've got this magnificent costume here. We've got one of the guys that, this is magnificent. Now, I don't know, you had this made, Brendan.
Yes.
It's an exact replica of an Elvis outfit. I believe it was his favourite.
This is called the Peacock, and it's Elvis's favourite suit.
The Peacock.
I think personally, everyone knows Elvis in a white suit of some form.
Just the beautiful work.
It's made by Elvis's company when he was alive, called BK Enterprises in Indiana.
Yeah.
You basically get sized up. They'll send you the made suit as just a shell. It'll be long, it'll be too big, and take photos, pin it all up, send it away. 3 months later, it'll come back. It's all finished.
I'm a little bit personal here, but you might not want to tell me, but how much would a costume like this cost?
This one's close to as dearest suit you can buy, apart from the embroidered suits.
Yeah.
This was $3,900 US.
And you would have what? How many of these costumes?
I think I've got 8.
So you spend a fair few bob on the old outfits.
Yeah, well, you do, because you know there's a difference between me wearing this here and me not wearing that there and something else. So it shows. So. This is the suit I won the Australian title in.
Yeah, and includes the belt.
Yeah,
does
the
that
belt.
Come with the whole outfit? That's all part of it.
It's all part of it. Yep.
Goes, I mean, they're
all heavy.
Mad to God.
Yeah, that's a lot of work, a lot of detail,
of
bling.
You could go diving with that thing.
Yeah.
It's like lead. It's so heavy.
I love the bling. It looks great.
Oh, it is. I mean, that's 70s, and that's what it was about. And no one else has ever anything like it.
No.
And it's instantly recognisable. It's
yes.
an Elvis outfit, you know.
Yep. You'd expect someone. Doing Elvis to have a white collar and something with flares.
Yeah.
And just so happens that I'm lucky enough to wear.
And Johnny here, I've got a belt of yours on here, is that right? This is yours?
Yes.
I don't want to clunk it around the table and make up, worry about all the mics, but you can tell me what's written on there. This is a replica?
Yeah, this is
an exact copy.
Yeah, exact copy of Elvis's gold belt. I'm just so. Proud.
This was presented to him, to Elvis, at his concert at the International Hotel, by the hotel, is that right?
Yeah. Yep.
Because he broke all the box office records, isn't it? That was just to show him, thank you for that.
Yep. Back in the day, Elvis was doing 2 shows a day, 365 days of the year.
Johnny Angel looks like he's just won the World Heavyweight Boxing Championship.
This one is, there was a competition, Elvis Down Under, 2014, and I won the amateur competition.
Fantastic.
So
now
I
want to talk to you about that because that's coming up very soon. Up at COSI, which is Wellington, obviously, and it's August?
2nd of September, is it?
2nd of September.
I think that's right.
Yeah, and they have people come there to compete as an Elvis from all over the country.
Yes, and Australia.
And Australia, so it's Australasia, the whole thing's Australasian.
Yes.
And how many performers would they get, probably?
There will be around about 16 to 20.
16 to 20 performers.
Yep.
That's amazing. And then they all compete to be the amateur Elvis tribute artists, Australasian, is that right?
Oh, there's two divisions.
Down under, I should say.
Yeah, yeah. There's two divisions, amateur division and a professional division.
Oh, so they do the professionals as
well. Yeah, so if you're, you know, real professional and you invest money into being an Elvis tribute artist, then you're going to professional division. And I won the on that time, the amateur division.
And you're going to be there this year?
I'm going to enter the professional division.
No on you, mate.
Good man. So, well done. Yeah, good on you.
So I've got to get to practice.
I think it's going
to
be fantastic. Yeah, just keep practicing. You've got it. I can't even do that. No, but, and I believe you're going to be a judge down there as well, Brendan.
Yes, I do my own shows and then as feature act.
Are you doing a feature? Yeah.
And then I'm also a judge.
You'll be just back from Memphis, so we'll know whether you're the champion. I really think you could do it. You know. Have you seen the sort of competition in America that you're up against?
I follow the competitions like you should do and see what's going on around the world. So and there's one on in Nashville this weekend. Some good names. There was, I do follow it, and it's important to follow. And they probably seen me and you know, because it's nice to know a little bit of homework about what's going on.
Is there anything that do you ever get given rules or anything like that?
The ultimate contest in America and the ones I've been through. You can't do anything vulgar or disrepute Elvis's name.
Yeah.
If you do, you're immediately dismissed.
Banned, dismissed, and never do it again. So.
Well, the chances of you doing it again become pretty slim because I'll remember you the next year.
No, I realize. So. Yeah. So there is a code of conduct all there.
And yeah.
There's a board that oversees it all.
Elvis had a massive standard, so we're trying to get to that standard, which is pretty hard to do. So if you stuff it up, you expect to, be kicked in the ass for it, I suppose.
Well, you guys aren't going to do that, and I'm sure.
No,
and we're just going to check out now. I like to do a classic clip, and I usually do a local Kiwi one. But having Elvis here, we're having an Elvis fest here, I'm telling you. And I'm going back to the movie Loving You, which first time I ever, I mean, I fell in love with Elvis. I'm telling you, I fell in love with him, just like everybody else.
Yep.
And he walked out onto the screen it was third movie, Loving You.
Yep.
He walks out on stage, he's got a cowboy thing with a red neckerchief, you'll see it in the clip. And he does Don't Be Cruel. It's just fantastic. And he is the king.
Well, you know I can be found sitting home all alone. If you can come around and please please telephone.
Wasn't he cool? Don't be cruel, Elvis the King. Oh, magnificent. See why I fell in love with him. I'm sure anyone out there who hasn't seen Elvis before, you must have hiding away on an island somewhere. But anyway, there he was, the man. And long live the king.
Yeah,
what do we say,
thank you,
man?
Much. Thank
long
much.
Live the king.
Thank you.
It's been a real pleasure talking to you. We could go on for another half an hour just chatting about it. I wish you every success with the upcoming gigs. Is there anywhere we can go and see you, Brendan? You're coming up soon. I think you've got a gig in Mangawai.
Yeah, Mangawai.
Because I was playing there a couple of weeks ago and they were talking about there's an Elvis coming to the town. And so it's, the word's out. So
I can't even remember the date because I do a lot of shows. But I guess the best thing to do is get on Facebook and Brendan Chase and have a look at me and see where I am next.
Yeah, Brendan Chase on Facebook. You follow him. It's great. Worth looking him up. And of course, Johnny Angel, he's on Facebook too. Lots of clips and things. And any gigs coming up, Johnny?
There's one on Friday. Brendan Chase is heading it. And,
okay.
That's insane. Tomorrow.
Oh, you go. I'm just clapping my hands because I'm so happy.
I'm the curtain raiser for Brendan Chase. He's performing tomorrow.
Look, you guys stick together because you're really good buddies. And, you always need someone to lean on here and there. And you guys just get a house on fire. Like I say, great having you here. And come back and tell me how you get on in the big competition in Memphis.
Yeah.
And Johnny Angel, hang in there, man. And just take that tribute concert to Samoa and rock their socks off. All right.
Malo.
Cheers, guys. And once again, thanks to my VIP guests, Brendan Chase and Johnny Angel. And thanks to you for joining me here on Rockin' the Planet. I'm Shane. I'll see you next week, same time, same place. Until then, keep on rockin'.